so you can check his pupils, and we have different eyes that we can put in. You can tell this one's a little bit more constricted.
These mannequins are like science fiction compared to what we have. There's not much you can't do with these things.
He's feeling a little nauseated.
The students continually on end of year, end of semester surveys would request that there be an on-site lab. And that's what triggered some of our initial efforts into trying to get a teaching lab here.
And that persistence paired with a commitment from Penn State Outreach, Lewistown Hospital, and Mifflin-Juniata Career and Technology Center gave way to a significant grant from the Pennsylvania Department of Labor and made a longtime dream come true.
I'm thrilled with Penn State being as collaborative as they've been and becoming more personal in a small community like this.
Especially at a time when the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania suffers from a nursing shortage, particularly in rural areas like Lewistown and Mifflin and Juniata counties.
As we look at this facility and we think of the future and the need for nurses out there, I think that this facility is going to play an important role in helping retrain a lot of people, or for the first time train people to get the opportunities to go into new fields.
Being a student, a mother, and not being able to travel that mountain every day, especially in the bad weather, this is great for us, and I'm thankful that it's here.
Monisha Druckemiller plans to get her RN and Bachelor of Science degree through the Penn State Learning Center in Lewistown. She says the timing of this multidisciplinary science and health lab is perfect for her and her classmates.
To have something in town that you can go to and continue your education and get what you need and get out there and start working, it's very important for us.
So they can stimulate a lot of just basic clinical skills.
Dr. Kirk Gilbert says it was important when planning the simulation lab to combine both basic science and clinical skills education.
Being a small community hospital, many of the students don't get to see a lot of the routine and even the non-routine cases with clinical skills education. And simulation is really at the forefront now of clinical skills training. The other thing that a simulation lab like this does is it allows a standardization where we can test students doing the same skills, the same procedures, the same clinical case, and compare them across a class or across a unit.
And ultimately, Gilbert says this facility will increase the diversity of science offerings to the community, from students graduating post-secondary education to people interested in biotech training. For Penn State Outreach, I'm Jamie Curott.